So we want to thank God for He has given us a life to come here again in the studio to share with you. We're going to share, before we share the word of God, let Pastor pray for the word.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for this morning. We give you all the glory and the honor for your word that we are going to listen. We pray that you bless the hearers, bless us as we share, that we shall not remain the same, and they shall not be the same again. May you receive all the glory and the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
So, ukanahusi mawele.
Yes, we want, ukanahusi, we want to thank God.
Because
our God is good.
He has
looked after us. He fights for us.
Our
God is good in all conditions.
We
thank Him for whatever message we get from this station. It is God who gives it. Because it talks about our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us in Romans
8
that there is no person who is blamed, who is condemned when he is in Christ.
So kubonanga kuba mu Yesu,
when you are in Jesus,
Yesu akuyeta wabanga kusohoka misango.
He helps us out of cases and condemnation.
Akusohoka misango ekikereba kubula mu bwefe.
All condemnation is upon us, he removes.
Kiyo kimisango kisi fabene kwekolera fabene.
Condemnation we have done ourselves.
Kiyo kimisango kisi kwasikira.
The condemnations we get from inheritance.
The
condemnations of things we have done without in knowledge and out of knowledge.
So kilo bana fakusima Yesu Kristo.
That's why we thank the Lord.
Bible no Mary.
The Bible says
Yesu yengene.
It is only Jesus.
Niyo wetsa koko nule
fwe. Who came to deliver us?
Amra wakurusa koko amamu haliba kumusango.
Who delivered us from condemnation and
the
judgment. When you have a condemnation, even if you have money,
so bani kimilembe tawe,
you have no peace.
Ngabe uli ni kumusango.
When you have, you are condemned.
Abe bahakwabiliyo walia.
Even if they give you food,
so lieni lukosi tawe.
You will not eat it with joy.
I don't even see that you
sometimes somebody even abandons
so
food.
So many people are going to be
you live in fear.
Abe bahakwatingu batindai.
Even if you get good clothes,
so kwara wabani kimilembe tawe.
You can't enjoy the clothes.
Adeso tingiramo wajabanga chikwara tawe.
You can't fit in them properly.
Wokubanga ulini kumusango.
Because you are accused.
Nezisi ukuisamu kamana.
But what gives us peace and strength?
Yes, Christ is going to move us.
Bible says, whoever is in Christ Jesus,
Salini uhuikiti watawe.
He is not condemned.
Bible meri wa hule hulefe.
He has released us.
Kuhama, huyambo kuhama, mama kumbi kuhingira mubulam.
From death to life.
So kulikuwa la kuhulu na kuhulu sheria.
We are seeing today.
Mumpera chesi fefu kulimo.
In the situation that we are.
Yes, kusualu ya bandu bosisan.
Jesus is for everybody.
Yes, kusualu wa mundo. Yes.
Jesus is for every human being.
Abe, akaba abolu mulos.
Whether you are a night dancer.
Abe, akaba abolu. Abe, akaba abolu mifi.
Well, even if you are a thief.
Abe, akaba abolu mweyani.
Whether you are immoral. Whether you are what type of sinner,
but
immediately you receive Christ as your Savior. He removes every condemnation from you. The Bible says
there
is no condemnation upon you. Even if you killed. And the people are condemning you.
Nenga hula mbuo kwa mangu wakana Yesu.
When you receive Christ Jesus in your
Yesu
life,
Yesu wakusinga.
He has cleansed you.
So kloba muti kwese ile kuno.
This morning.
We tsano kamana twani
nenyi. We have come to share with you.
Wali wembera ili mvula mwefe.
There must be there might be a condition.
Yes kunyakwe baza kwese nyili yake ende yache tawe.
Situation in your life.
Kukanikira kuloma iye kwigizwa kumusango.
We are talking about being condemned.
Ukanikurera kumbera yesi kulima mumbuke ya saina.
What to bring you to this situation?
Bisebilo nyabo nembera yesi wolimo.
Sometimes the situation you might be through.
Kakulolele busa kufurza akabanga barambi ba government.
Like the workers of civil servants.
Baliyo ba tetironi ba kola bariena.
People have gotten loans in banks.
Are kumbuke iye longe ya corona ina.
And this situation of
COVID,
they have sent you at home. They have told you sit at home. As you sit at home, there is no work. You
can
no longer make money.
How old are private sectors?
People who are working in the private sector. You left and now you don't have any salary.
So, what
you are used to a place where you
are
getting something. You
are
just
ready.
And they are not demanding.
So, what do you think?
Then you find yourself in a hardship.
So, what do you think?
Life like that.
It
used to be on children of Israel. When they were in Israel, they lived in such a life.
Like
in a life of rent. A life of oppression. They had no peace. They didn't have hope.
So Bible Mary.
The Bible says. When Moses was leading them to the
Moses land,
they thought maybe Moses had planned for them to
be in
their way. They were fearful and afraid.
Nenga sebasiole leona hulutwe.
One time it came to pass.
Mary ngabola kukwambuka.
When they passed crossed the Red Sea.
Ngabola kuola kumilembe kyawe.
When they reached the peace.
Bible Mary bafana bali kurora.
They were like dreaming.
Akuike musiandikwa.
We are going to learn from one scripture.
Musabisa Sabuli.
In the book of Psalms.
Sabuli 12 mukaga.
Psalms 126.
Sabuli 12 mukaga.
126 of Psalms. What does the Bible tell us? Yes. The Bible says.
Then our mouth. We are filled with laughter. And our tongue. With singing. Then they said among the heathens, the Lord has done great things. The Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. Whereof we are glad. So this morning here, the Bible is telling you and me that when they turned from their captivity, that we were like them who are dreaming. They were dreaming. You know, when you are in a circumstance and somebody tells you that you are going to be released, and for you, you had the confidence that you were going to die, that you will not move out of this body. But when somebody tells you that you are going to move out of this problem,
so
you cannot be sure of what of the message coming to you. So this morning, may I speak something to you? That we are in the time of Corona, where everybody is expecting to die. Everybody have, most of the people have surrendered. They have surrendered their lives. Some of them have even made some covenants. That they will no longer be there. Some have sold their properties. They have eaten. Thinking that they let us eat and forget because we shall not be there no longer. but here the Bible say, that the children of Israel, as they reached somewhere, as they reached a place, and they began enjoying. So the Bible tells you and me that they were like, they were dreaming. But the fact was, they were not dreaming, but it was a reality. So this morning here, many people have been in the lockdown. The churches have been in the lockdown. The schools and all the institutions have been in the lockdown. But I want to speak the good message this morning. There is a message today, this morning of deliverance, that God, that God is going to deliver us. And God has already begun delivering us. Because in Uganda, we have not received any death gas. So, which means there is healing. Hallelujah. That's why we encourage ourselves. I want to thank God so much for my bishop. For him, he says, I will never sing for Corona. Because Corona has no life. But I sing for Jesus because Jesus has life. So when we believe in Jesus, as the Bible says in the book of Romans, that there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. So when we believe in Jesus, even this corona here is nothing. When we believe in Jesus, God can move us. Remember in March, in March, people were lacking food. In fact, there was no food. There was no money because of the lockdown. But now, you see now today, people are now eating maize. People are eating beans. And the corona is reducing. So now as corona is reducing, we see the yields are increasing. So, and as the yield like that, somebody thinks like he's dreaming. It is not a dream. But it is the reality that God has moved us to another level. God has moved us to another stage. This is the level of faith. It is a level of faith. Like for those ones who have been there, no, there are those who have been actually not even having home sales. They could not even fellowship at home. There are those who have been fellowshipping, but in fear. But we want to encourage you this morning that there is a freedom which is coming. There is a freedom of faith which is coming. God is creating a new faith in you. That when we believe in God, God will do a tremendous thing in your life, which you will not even think about it. And you will not think that maybe it is there. But the fact is, it is there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning, we speak that the corona is nothing. This morning, we speak that the witchcraft you have been hearing of, all of them are nothing. This morning, that all the threats you have been seeing, all of those words are nothing. God is above everything. God is above all the burdens you are having. God is above all the problems you are having. This morning here, God is looking unto you. What are you having? That's what the Bible says. God asked Moses,
that
what you have, what are you having? God wants to see what you are having. From the point what you are having in your hand is where God is going to make you starting from there. The beginning will be from there.
So,
and when God performs through you yourself, through your hand. So you will think that maybe am I the one who have done it? And when you raise, you're not the one you're not the one who have done it. And then you say, but who have done it? Now you begin doubting. Then from that point, it will be like a dream. This is like you are dreaming. But the fact is, the Lord we are serving is not a God of dreams, but is a God of the reality. Our God is a miracle worker. Our God is a healing God. The devil is a killer, but God is a healer. So the devil is gay, but God is H. So the devil is a healer. But God is a healer. So this morning, we must focus our minds on God. Let us put our ears on the Lord. Which voice are you hearing? Because when they speak outside there, that millions of people have died. Now when they speak about millions of people have died, now somebody also brings death. And now you marry death now in your home. That any time we are going to die. Let me eat now because I'm going to die. Let me go and get dowry from my daughter because I'm going to die. You may eat your things, but eventually you not die. You not die. After finishing your things, and you are not dead. Now, what will you do? So the Bible says that a wise man even plans for his death. In planning for your death, doesn't mean that you destroy your things, but you spare. You must spare them. You spare them to be there. Say that tomorrow when you die, those who remain will begin from there. But if you crush everything, now tomorrow when you die, you will not have a record. So, but the word of encouragement in this situation that we are undergoing, that when they were released from their captivity, they were like dreaming. Then their mouths were full of laughter. They began laughing. And their tongues were full of singing. So this time, somebody must be singing for God. We must sing for God. We sing because of His goodness. Because He has life. Because when you look at these witch doctors here, they can eat everything of ours. Sometimes you can go there. They are the ones you need. You can go there. Maybe you want them to help you. That your business can be lifted up. But when you reach there, for them they have no business. The ones they are wanting from you, for them they are not rich. They have no wholesales. So that's what the Bible says. I like so much the message that the bishop brings. That people suffer because of lack of knowledge. How can you go to somebody who has nothing, that is going to promote your business, that is going to give you money? When he himself is not rich, and he is promising you a vehicle, when he himself has no bicycle. So for us, we suffer Because we lack a knowledge. So but the Bible says here that when you trust in God, and one day He remove you from your captivity, He will remove you from those curses. When you move out of those curses, and you become a blessing. When you become a blessing, you begin supporting others. The one who have been a beggar, but now you are the one now giving out. So you will feel now. You feel like you are dreaming, but the fact is, God has given unto you. And the Bible has told us again that even their enemies said that their God have done for them. That's why sometimes, even if you are passing under different circumstances, under hard conditions, you are not allowed even to curse your enemy. Don't curse your enemy. Because these enemies of yours are the ones who are coming to witness. They will witness about you. The ones going to lift up your God. You see, and the children of Israel, they are not the ones who are saying, but their enemies are the ones saying that their God have done for them great things. Because He has moved them out of their problems. So this morning here, this is a message of deliverance. It is a message of freedom. This part of the circumstances you are undergoing, there is a fig tree ahead of you. There is a fig tree ahead of your life. There is a fig tree in your home. Because our God is a miracle worker. He is just looking at us. What are we saying? Where are our minds lying? When God sees our minds are lying on Him, even if you can take time, for us, immediately He is taking time, but He has displaced a day that you will be satisfied. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bishop, what can you say? Hallelujah.
God is so good. Like for us in Manafa
day.
We used to, one time people wanted to demonstrate. Because we don't have a road. Electricity is not passing. And the people in Magari. And some politicians threatened to walk. Naked, from Bali. When you walk naked, who feels the pain? And who feels the shame? But this is what people were saying. They wanted to walk because they wanted to see a road. But right now, we have a
tarmac
road up to Ruhakaka. We are having electricity wires. We are having piped water. Young people I used to pray with in the church.
Mukanis.
Sometime in the 90s day.
Around
92 day. I think we came to Butiro around 98
day.
2000. We were praying in our church. We were saying, God, transform this place, which looks isolated, which looks abandoned, which is swampy, which has no proper building. There were only departed Asian houses. We started praying.
You
said, God, transform. And you promised. Wherever your foot shall stay. There I will bless. You will be a blessing there. Declare whatever you put in your
stead.
Ah, that one is your city now. And we started praying. We started, we want water. We want electricity. And now when young people, they keep reminding me, say, Muse, you remember? You used to tell us about the road and the water and the... And literally, almost all of these things have come to pass. And many others are coming. We have a mining in
Busum.
And we have a Tamarkt road going up to
Luka.
We have electricity passing by. My, we used to pass through mud with our vehicles and you feel real hell
of the road.
Going to Mbale from Butiru,
it
will take about 1 hour. You are dodging sometimes you get stuck in mud. So, as the man of God was saying, it is true. It doesn't matter. What situation you are going through. Sometimes you go through hard times. But have hope. Believe in God. And pray. Have hope. Believe in God. And then pray. And as you pray, in Mark 11:22, the Bible says, when you pray, believe. That you are receiving. Yes.
Yeah.
And if you don't believe, then you
are
not receiving. When you pray, pray believing that what you are asking
for,
it will come to pass surely. And it will be done. Amen.
Amen.
So let's not have lose hope. When you look at the children of God, like Moses, Moses had passed through hard times. To the extent of being abandoned on the river with a basket. Because there was a threat to destroy Israelite children. Moses was abandoned.
And
he was picked in a basket by the daughter of a king. He would have perished.
And
that was a hardship. That was an escape and a survival for the fittest. You see all the Bible, God, people that God blessed. They passed through hard times. Joseph was hated by his brother and sold to the merchants. Merchants who were buying slaves. And then they put him, threw him in a pit and took his garment to the father and said, "You are," told the father, "your son was killed by an animal. His clothes is here, you see even blood."
And then
they pretended like they are sorrowful. Sorry, Musei.
Bebe, kolo kolo, ngababa, lini, kunji, bari, pole, papa. Bari, bona, yingu, jiga, jiriano. Before
we could fight and deliver him, the animal had
eaten.
And in fact, we struggled,
we caught
and we got the clothes. Here is the cloth.
With
the blood on it.
They
were lying.
Come up there.
They had sold him. And where they sold him,
as a slave,
he became, because of the God's hand upon him, he became a prime minister. He helped many nations. He supplied
the
food.
Why because
of the dreams he had and interpretation of dreams, God promoted him to the level of prime minister. Now we don't know, brother. And my sister. I don't know which situation you are going through. You might be through a situation where you are abandoned.
Yes,
where you are abused.
Yes,
where the husband is mistreating you. So when you are mistreated, don't get annoyed. Don't curse yourself. You put your attention on God. In your heart. And in your quiet time. When you are alone. Separate yourself. Go somewhere. And say God. You see all whatever I'm going through. I am your child. Don't abandon me. Come to my deliverance. I need your power. I need your hand. May you intervene. Intervene in this situation. I am in the fire. Like in Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Can you come and deliver me from this situation, from this condition? Lord, you are a battle fighter. You are a chain breaker. And you are my burden carrier. Carry my burden away. Carry my shame away.
Oh,
remove all my heaviness.
My
heaviness of heart. And deliver me. And save me. Oh, there are many people today who are going through conditions. They are passing through circumstances. Sometimes when you are passing through a circumstance, you think this is mine.
When
you hear another one, oh my God. God, you say I'm better off. Have you ever seen people with cancer and is hanging in his face? Is seeing only seeing with one eye?
When you're mudarini, cancer wa muri yi moni wa kwai tso se kure ariari ni moni ndwela yonge ne kure kwai tso se yi mumbi.
Have you seen somebody walking on his buttocks and his hands on the floor?
Ali wo mundu mulake ndira kuzo kukumata kwati kongene kama ona kaya kali is even at mbale there.
Yes, he has no legs.
Sare ko ni bikire ta akendira busa si buchu busa akendira busa kama tafali kongene na mala kama ona kali as.
Now if you go to those toilet places in the town, they are pieced everywhere. He has to move all the way through.
I think what's in for me, maybe it's a jammy jam, maybe come and I really is very much. I remember what came to watch.
Recently, I saw on WhatsApp.
I'm just saying, I'm on WhatsApp.
A man
Umusan,
whose testicles are like a sack of beans.
Yes, I'm on a guy,
he can even put it in front of him and he uses it as a table.
Huge.
A sack.
Esau.
When he cry, when he's climbing steps to go to some upstairs house. Somebody has to support him. This is too unbearable. It looks like something which is not, but it's real.
Things are there.
And then when you look at yourself, you should thank God. You should give glory to God. For making me. Some people just because he's too dark. I wish I was brown. Every size has its advantage. Everything you have on you has its advantage. Did you know? Some people don't like to be albinism. Albino.
Umulondo.
But did you know?
Hey,
there are women. We have a brother. He was one time our headmaster. But he married a beautiful girl. From
Mufumbo.
You ask yourself, but why this woman accepted? Do you know what? That women have are very strange. There is a woman who got married to the champion in ugliness in Kampala.
You wonder why this woman is married to Sebabi. Bakana bulindi.
Something they know.
Isn't this Bamanya?
But
the one I'm going to.
There is no other person who will admire.
Impao Mundugo, look and I'm competent in the Hobago saying,
I will be alone.
Never the Jemali Rahuyo.
No women will disturb me.
Impao Baba, I forgot to give Mamanda, because
who Everybody is admiring. Everybody wants to go with
it.
But a woman wants security. Has the man got a job? Has the man got some money? And has can he cater for me and provide? Other things, whether he is crippled, is I'm after my security, protection, and alone. So the Lord is good. In all things, God is willing to help us. God can help us in every
situation.
When we put our hope in Him, when we trust in Him, my brother, God is able. can deliver us.
Where are you going?
He can change all our circumstances.
And
you want to pray with someone. And you want to put your trust in the Lord. You also want to put your faith in Jesus.
And go can hura kusubira.
Pray with us.
And
you close your eyes. And pray this simple prayer with me.
Say, Lord Jesus,
I come to you. I believe what I've heard.
If Kirisa this in
I am a sinner. Have mercy over me.
Man bless.
Forgive my sins. And deliver me. Write my name.
And
in the book of life. And remove it from the book of death. From today, I believe, Lord Jesus, you are my Savior. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen.
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 You can ring us
on number
0772-95-81-92. 70.
Musav not.
I repeat.
Niram.
0772.
Not Musav Zavitibi.
95.
Siendetran.
81. Snanendwer.
And 70. Musav not.
Airtel can be.
Yam Airtel.
075.
Not Musav Trano.
4.
Sine.
95.
Sienda Trano.
81.
Snanendwer.
70.
And
we shall deliberate and give you more counseling.
In Jesus' name.
May God bless you. I've been Pastor Mwaka.
I've been Erasmus Mwaka. Say Emma.
Emma, send Pastor Mwaka Erasmus. Utiru Manafa.
Wame utiri Manafa.
Ibunyiza.
Ibunyiza. Bless you.